We enter a half-built shack. Shack is kind of hut. So it was a partially constructed hut. In one part of it, thatched with dead grass, the same grass which is used in huts, is a firewood stove over which sits a large vessel of sizzling spinach leaves. On the ground, a large aluminium platters are more chopped vegetables. A frail young woman is cooking the evening meal for the whole family. Through eyes filled with smoke, she smiles. She welcomes the author. She is the wife of Mukesh's elder brother. Not much older in years, although she was not much older than Mukesh. She was a responsible person and worthy to get respect from the family as Bahu, as the daughter-in-law. She has begun to command respect as the Bahu, the daughter-in-law of the house, already in charge of three men, her husband, Mukesh, and their father. So she took care of three men in the family, her husband, Mukesh, and their father. When the older man enters, she gently withdraws behind the broken wall and brings her veil closer to her face. So as Mukesh's father entered the house, the daughter-in-law hid behind the wall and covered her face behind her veil, her ghungat. It was a tradition. As custom demands, daughter-in-law must veil their faces before male elders. Same she was doing. In this case, the elder is an impoverished bangle maker. Impoverished means very poor. So this father is a very poor bangle maker. Despite long years of hard work, first as a tailor, then a bangle maker, he has failed to renovate a house, send his two sons to school. All he has managed to do is teach them what he knows, the art of making bangles. So this poor father, he worked very hard in different things, in different business. So first he worked as a tailor, then as a bangle maker. He was still not able to either renovate the house or send his sons to school. So he had just managed to teach his children the skill of making bangles. It is his karam, his destiny, says Mukesh. Grandmother, who has watched her own husband go blind with the dust from polishing the glass of bangles. Can a God-given lineage ever be broken? She implies. So Mukesh's grandmother justified her son by saying that he was destined to make bangles as it had been their family profession. She had seen her husband become blind due to the dust from polishing the glass bangles. She said that their family had got this art of bangle making from God, and so they had to carry on the tradition.